So a long awaited for video, and I'm sorry it took so long, but it takes ages to do some of these things. And what I've been doing in all this time is making this. This is our battery. As you can see, it actually really is about the size of a ream of paper. Now, because there's 500 sheets in there, I've printed up 500 sheets, banged them all together, wired them up properly, and put a kettle lead on it. Now, I've put a kettle lead on it for a very specific reason, because we bought this. I love this. It's actually just an electric bicycle. It's so underpowered that in the UK we don't need a helmet, we don't need a license, we don't need road tax, we can just sit on this and go. So I thought it'd be a bit of fun for nipping up and down the shops when we finish this experiment. Main reason was to do the experiment to show that we could run a vehicle on one of our batteries. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the battery out that came with it. It's right here, incidentally. Oh. Put that one aside and put our super duper battery in there. It's actually quite a bit smaller than the battery that came out, incidentally. Plug it in. Okay. Get the keys. Fingers crossed, guys! Ho 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 ho! It's working. It's working. I'm going to take this down to the shops. Hang on a sec.
Yay!
Oh! We got lights?
We got lights.
Cool. We've got everything in. This is very cool. Give it a run! So, here's Steve testing longevity. I tell you, he's going to be at this all day. Action shot. This thing's caused quite a stir. Just about everybody in the park wants to have a go. That's one of our neighbours.
You are one crazy boy.
How long have you been back here? About
100 kilometres.
Yeah, I just wanted to go straight out of the
stuff. Yeah, a little hour.
What are they doing?
Isn't it?
Well,
it
must be there 20, about 20 up the road. I was following a van.
Easily you were. Yeah, easy, mate, easy. You know there's a speedo on it, don't you?
Yeah.
What's the speedo of that? There you go.
When
it
takes
5 minutes, we're doing 20 easy.
So if you've got a crasher, you've got a little billy, I can say
that. So that was a lot of fun. Actually, that motor is a 250-watt motor, and in Britain, it's legal to ride it on the street without a helmet. It actually counts as an electric bicycle, so it's perfect. It looks like a scooter, it's actually a bicycle, but a lot of fun. Now, it's a bit difficult to tell what was in that bound-up package, and of course, we had to bind that package up because we had to put it in a battery, in a scooter. But it's basically 500 of these. They just made loads and loads of these. I'm not an exciting guy. I do not lead an exciting life. Making hundreds of these things is not a lot of fun, I can tell you. It took quite a long time. It took a long time because I had to do lots of tests and I had to make lots of these things. And you can see the active material on the plate there. On the other side, it's just paper. So the paper acts as the separator, and the active material is held here, and we have to clip to that with a collector plate. And that's all we do. We just have to make these things up. and build up that battery like that, just using layer after layer after layer of this. Now, I've done it this way because, to be honest, I didn't finish these. These ones are just left over. Now, I've painted one side so you can see that it's paper, but actually what you do is paint both sides. So you print on this side, you print on this side. The ink that you print on will sit on the paper, and this paper then acts as a separator. Now, in case you're wondering how thick this is, I've got a thickness meter. And we can have a quick gauge of how thick that is. There you go, that's about 65 microns thick. So that bit is 65 microns thick, which is why when you put 500 of them together, it's about the size of a ream of paper. Now, that's how we made that other one. But it's a bit difficult to tell from that, so these are our little laptop. This is where we started, if you remember. Actually, where we actually started was little bits of this. We started little bits of these and we made up tiny, tiny ones. Then we made up bigger versions, then we made the really big version. And this really shows you what the structure is like and really how thin it is. It's so thin that you, in fact, really can't see the separation there. These two plates are clamped together and the cell's actually in there. And you really can't see. That one's about 2 square inches. Now, we sent this off for verification. And that process got a bit screwed up, unfortunately, which is a bit of a nuisance. But I've taken a bit more charge of that verification process. So though it's fun to see this thing working, in order to give you some characteristics of what that battery is, which is probably about 1 kilowatt hour, it's going to take me a long time. I've got to run that bicycle home, to and from home, quite a number of times. It's probably going to go about 100 kilometres, something like that. I only live about 15 kilometres away. I'm going to be riding that bicycle for days just to run that battery down. So it's going to take a long time to do characterisation of a big battery like that. It takes no time at all to do the characterisation of something little like this. So this is going to get sent off for verification again, but this time I'm in charge of it, so it should happen a bit more quickly. So we've made up a load of little models there to go for verification. We've got our big battery and it's now running a scooter. Yay! So we're actually almost there. All we have to do is get the verification results. And the verification results will tell you exactly, in proved up figures, what's on that. Now, I think it's about 1 kilowatt hour. And it is, it's round about that. This little 2 inches by 2 inches thing will run that motor for about 10 minutes or so, something like that. You can have a rough calculation of how much energy is in there to give you a rough idea. The verification will tell us exactly what's on there, and then we can calculate up and have an exact, well, exact. It'd be plus and minus 5%, it's never exact. But it'll give you a good idea of what there is, and that's our very next step, and probably our last step. Anyway, I hope that was fun. Thank you for waiting, and thank you for watching.